Good morning, everyone. Thank you for starting the day out with me. Key West played host to the fastest and the most powerful offshore race boats in the world. It was time for the 33rd annual Key West World Championships. Another great week of racing is in the books. We'll have all the results for you this morning.
There is no sporting event any more exciting than this. WHM picked up a turn buoy. I see it on the front. Oh, that's going to cost him some money. Look at this battle here now. As we always do, we come back to Key West, Florida for the granddaddy of offshore racing, the World Championship. And we are seeing some awesome racing. Keep your eye on this, ladies and gentlemen. This is tight, tight racing.
Clay, thank you so much for being on with me this morning. Let's get right into the Key West World Championships. Now, Clay, there was some drama coming into the week between a lot of drama, but specifically between Geico and the Spirit of Qatar. How did that play out?
You know, behind the scenes, we heard that those guys were friends. You would never know it. It was a smackdown. And I'm so shocked that Geico won. I mean, if you really think about it, those were two different boats. The Spirit of Qatar is a 50-foot turbine, 44-foot standard piston motor in the Geico machine. It was a smackdown for two laps. And then, unfortunately, the Qatar burned. I mean, on turn one, he literally caught on fire. And Geico went on, in their style, just to win. And they did it eloquently. But in the drivers' meeting last night, there was another smackdown. They challenged each other for next year, and they both said, beware, we're coming.
So they're already ready for another drama-filled event.
They are so ready. They are so ready. I know that the texts are blazing between those two guys, but you'd never know it.
Right. And Scotty and Mark, they probably have huge smiles on their face still to this day.
I talked to Scotty last night. I said, this is not your first rodeo. It's not your first world championship. He said, no, but it's my sweetest world championship. So they love this one.
Good. All right, Clay, there was a new class this year called the Superboat class.
Right.
How was that new beginning?
Well, you know, the neat part was it was launched last year at this race, and it has grown now to over 10 entrants, which is huge. And even with that, we expect 15 to 20 for next year. It has decreased the price. It has slowed the racing down a little bit. So if you're going 125 as opposed to 165, so what? Mm-hmm. But it's kept the boats close together. So when you're out there watching boats running after, 14 laps, you like to know they're racing each other. And with that many in that class, with equal playouts, it's a great class. Problem was, the class winner and the elite of the field, J.R. Noble from the Steel team, broke a drive, out of his control. Everything was checked out. He flat broke one of the drives. So you don't do well with only one prop running if you're a catamaran. And that's what happened.
Clay, what happened to Lucas Oil?
That's so sad. You know, we had all high hopes for Lucas. They brought half of England over here with their telemetry system. They knew from that cockpit everything that was going on. They knew how fast they were going. They knew really everything on that engine. And it was a battle between the high tech and the good old boys. And Twisted Metal, the good old boys, did win. Why? Faster boat. And that's a breakout class. And what that means is that if you exceed a speed, which is 116, then you lose. Any moment you get a rogue wave or a little wind that'll help you over 116, you're out. You're done. Mm-hmm. Well, they kept it at a conservative 115 the whole race. Old school, nah. Billy Gluck, he just hammered down and bumped against the rev limiter, bumped against that 116, and won the race. But friendly foes. But next year, now, Lucas is coming back, and they're going to take home a title.
Mm-hmm. They're ready for it.
They are so ready for it.
All right, Clay. Where do you see the future of superboat racing headed to?
Exciting. I've been involved in offshore powerboat racing now 16, 17 years. And I've been here twice with, I've been here with two different sanctioning bodies. So I've watched Key West really grow ups and down with this huge event that comes to town. The biggest problem we've had are fields, the size of the field, the number of boats running. It's expensive. Now what's happening in, with Superboat and with John Carbonell is he's equalizing the field, he's pulling back on the horsepowers, he's making it more cost effective to get involved in powerboat racing, and he's increasing the numbers of boats. Are we going to have 100 boats again soon? Nah. But we are moving up. We're bumping on 40. Next year I'll project 50. I'll go on the line, project 50 boats. Well, then you've got a real race. And you're not watching boats go around and around like paint dry. You've got some real competition if you have enough boats. Go in the right direction. I'm thrilled, excited. And he's picking up venues. He's got panhandle venues now. He's got a new venue on the west coast of Florida. It's really developing into a neat, neat series for sponsors and for racers alike.
Good. Well, that is exciting news. Yeah. And now, Clay, there has been some controversy about Key West hosting the World Championships in the future. Where do we stand on that issue?
Tough issue. I was on the radio yesterday with Fat Yannis, and he made the comment, and I think it's correct. He said that this week brings in $13.5 million of what he called clean money. Well, clean money, big money. I came back and said that means there's a lot of silver Patron out there, but it really does mean that there's a lot of money that comes in because the races are here. I'm kind of amazed if Key West and all the supporting sanctioning bodies and the Tourism Development Board would allow a few thousand dollars to stand in the way of 13, maybe growing to $15 million of clean money coming to the seat. I think, gut hunch, I think it'll stay. But you know what? We all need to team together. It's not going to stay if we don't do something.
Absolutely. And it definitely is one of Key West's largest and most popular events. So I hope to see it back here next year.
Let's think positively. And, you know, I just think that we had great media coverage this year. We had Channel 87 and 19, which was carrying us all the way up to Boca Raton. We had simulcast with Sports Radio 1600, and we were over the web, audio and two television signals, the signal here as well as the Super Bowl's international signal. It was a well-founded, rich media event this time. Great future.
Absolutely. Well, Clay, thank you for being on, and thanks for all the work that you have done with the World Championships. I'm going to take a quick break right now. I'll be back after these messages. Stay with me.